So there are lots and lots of other interesting applications of asymmetric cryptography. We'll see some of those later in Unit 5. But for now, I want to focus on how to actually build an asymmetric crypto system. What we want to build is what's known as a trapdoor one-way function. So a one-way function would be a function that is easy to compute in one direction and hard to compute in another direction. With asymmetric crypto, well, we need to reveal this function. We want the reverse to still be hard, but we want some way to be able to do the reverse easily if we know some secret. So that's our trapdoor. We want to be able to, if you have some secret key, you can do the inverse. If you don't, you can't. So that's what makes it an asymmetric crypto system, that it's hard to do in the reverse direction unless you have this extra key. But revealing the easy way to do the forward direction does not reveal the easy way to do the reverse direction. So Diffie and Hellman envisioned such a crypto system in the 1976 paper that we talked about last unit, but they didn't devise a function that had this property. The first crypto system to successfully have this property is the RSA crypto system, and that'll be the focus for the rest of this unit.